The Madison Opera is celebrating its 50th season, and beginning the season will be The Marriage of Figaro, which will be performed the first weekend in November. And here to tell us more about it is General Director Alan Nadlin. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
Now, this afternoon, we have Opera Up Close. Tell us a little bit about what Opera Up Close is all about.
Well, we feel that opera, which is very complex, we realize that if we can just allow our audience members to get a little insight into a piece beyond reading program notes or going onto our website, if you can get some access into opera, meeting the artists. So we have artists that come to Opera Close and talk about what it's like being an opera singer, what it's like to sing this specific opera. We go through the history of the opera, though, in a very non-academic way. Everything is very entertaining and accessible to make sure that opera at Madison Opera is very accessible.
So tell us a little bit about The Marriage of Figaro. I know it's kind of a complex story, but maybe just the high points?
Sure. It's quite convoluted, but in a good way, and it adds to the comedy of this. It's sort of your classic situation comedy before TV was around, of an in-house situation where there is a master and two servants who are trying to get married, one of them being Figaro, thus The Marriage of Figaro. He wants to marry Susanna, and yet the Count, who they work for, is also interested in Susanna, and he has a wandering eye with any woman and would love to just interrupt their marriage or perhaps just delay it a bit so that he can have his fun. And it's just various other sub-stories that are going on that it's really a wonderful comedy.
And there is some familiar music in The Marriage of Figaro, too, written by Mozart.
This
was his last...
Not his last opera, but towards the end, but certainly his most, well, you could say perhaps his most famous, along with Don Giovanni and the Magic Flute. But as you said, the music is very familiar. In fact, just from the downbeat of the overture, that's probably perhaps the most popular piece from the opera.
And you hear that a lot of times, too, in popular situations with television shows have used it, so that
movies,
is very familiar.
Movies, commercials, most notably in The Shawshank Redemption, there's a duet between the Countess and Susanna, and there's a wonderful scene in the movie where Morgan Freeman starts hearing the music as Tim Robbins has played it on a recording that goes through the prison system, and all the prisoners stop and listen. It's just a beautiful moment that really highlights how beautiful this music is.
And the story, actually, for the entire opera can still have some contemporary meaning to it, too.
It has tremendous relevance. There are still men with wandering eyes, of course, and, and marriages that go through a lot of comic, diversions before they get to the altar.
So we are in the performance space right now where you've been rehearsing.
We're in the rehearsal space.
The rehearsal space, I'm sorry.
We couldn't fit an audience here. The audience will go into Overture Hall. This is just for 2 weeks. We rehearse the staging here in Promenade Hall at Overture Hall, at Overture Center, and then we move on to stage. But this is to simulate what the stage will look like just with mock-ups of set pieces.
So let's run through the basics then. Opera Up Close will be this afternoon.
1 to 3 at the Museum of Contemporary Art.
Okay.
Admission is $20 or free for students.
Wonderful. And then the actual performance will be November 5th and 7th.
5th and 7th in Overture Hall. Tickets available through the Overture Center box office.
And they are very affordable, too. They go as low as $16,
That's
right?
That's correct. That's correct.
Perfect. So opera is accessible to all. And come enjoy Opera Up Close. If you don't have an opportunity to do that, you can certainly come and enjoy The Marriage of Figaro. Thanks so much.